I decided that I'm going to do a little bit of a chameleon series here on my channel for the month of September. Now, for those of you who don't own chameleons, don't like chameleons, whatever, don't worry, I'm still going to be doing other videos pertaining to my other animals, my move and all that stuff, but I thought that it'd be fun to have a little bit of a chameleon series on here because I do have a lot of people who come to me for chameleon care, asking me all kinds of questions, so that's what this month is going to be about here on my channel. We're going to be doing some chameleon videos. So to start off this series, I want to dive right in to a very common question, and that is, do chameleons make good pets? Now I'm going to start off by saying there isn't just one answer for this, and this really applies to any animal out there. There's no such thing as a perfect pet or an awful pet because different pets are going to suit different people's needs. So while a chameleon might be a great pet for me, it might be an awful pet for you. So in order to figure out if a chameleon is a good or bad pet, we're going to look at some pros and cons of them. So then that way you guys can get an idea of what owning a chameleon is like, and then you can decide if it's going to be a good pet or a bad pet for you. So let's start off with the pros. So now the reason that a lot of people will be interested in chameleons is because they tend to be very beautiful, fascinating, unique lizards. If you're into reptiles, chances are you might like chameleons because they're pretty interesting. Now, as a chameleon owner myself, I can confidently say that chameleons do make a good pet for me, but I can also confidently say that they don't make good pets for a lot of people, depending on what you're looking for. So first, we're gonna talk about the pros, as I mentioned, and then we'll go into some cons. So one of my favorite things about chameleons is they're diurnal, which means that they are awake during the daytime and they sleep during the nighttime, similar to humans. A lot of other pet reptiles out there are nocturnal, meaning they're awake at nighttime and they sleep during the day. So because chameleons are diurnal, you get to see them more often than you would with, say, a leopard gecko. If you're awake during the daytime, chances are your chameleon's going to be awake as well. They might be out in their cage basking, doing a little bit of exploring, eating, so they are a fascinating animal to watch, in my opinion. Chameleons are pretty unique lizards. When you think of a lizard, people either think of a chameleon or a gecko, typically, but when you compare the two, they're very different, both look-wise and like personality-wise, care-wise. There's a lot of difference between chameleons and other animals. They're very, very unique animals. The way that they move about branches, the way that they climb, the way that they explore and, you know, see their surroundings. It's very unique, and to me, it's very fascinating. One thing I really like about chameleons is they all seem to have their own distinct personality. I do find them to be very personable lizards, and they're all very different. I have multiple chameleons, and I can confidently say that all of them are very, very different from one another. Some of them are way more outgoing, and I don't mean outgoing in the sense of like a human outgoing, but outgoing for a lizard, if that makes sense. They're more confident. Some of them are more shy. Some are a little more reclusive. Some of them are just very eager to like eat and stuff. It's really hard to describe it because a lizard's personality is so different than a human's, but regardless, they do all have their own personalities, and because of that, I find them really fascinating and fun to own. An obvious bonus to chameleons that a lot of people probably like about them is the fact that they just tend to be very beautiful animals. Now, there's so many different species of chameleon out there, and with that, there's so many different sizes and colors and patterns. So whether you like your standard green lizard or a rainbow lizard, if you like small ones, big ones, there's probably going to be one out there that you will like. Panther chameleons, for example, are some of the most colorful chameleons out there. They have just a rainbow of colors, which is very beautiful. And then you have veiled chameleons, for example, who have that big cask on their head, which is really fascinating. Then you get into like pygmy chameleons like Brugesia, who just look very, very unique and fascinating. They're small. Then you have carpet chameleons who come in all different colors and sizes, and there's just so many out there. Parsons chameleons who get really big, get like quadricornis and Jacksoni that have these really impressive horns on their face. There's so many different colors, patterns, shapes, sizes, whatever, when it comes to chameleons, and I think that makes them incredibly fascinating. I currently have 3 species of chameleon in my care. I have had more in the past, and every single one of them has been significantly different from one another. Another thing I really like about chameleons, this is just kind of a little thing, but they're fun to feed and fun to watch eating. Now, chameleons have these like magnificent eyes on them. If you've ever looked at a chameleon before, they have these big eyes on either side of their head, which they can move independently from one another. So they can have one looking this way and one looking forward. And when you feed them, both of those eyes will lock onto their prey, and then they shoot out that tongue, which is quite impressive and always interesting for me to watch. Now, even though I have multiple years of experience owning chameleons and watching them hunt never gets tiring to me. I always find it so interesting seeing them lock eyes on an insect and then shoot their tongue out like a foot in front of them. It's so interesting to watch to me. So those are some things that I really like about chameleons. Now, you may have noticed though, none of those things really included hands-on activity. And this would be where some of the cons might come in for some people, and where you might start to realize that a chameleon isn't a great pet for you. While chameleons are very interesting, beautiful, fascinating animals, they're really not an animal that you're going to want to handle often, if really at all. I personally only handle my chameleons really when necessary. I don't take them out just to have like some playtime or anything like that, because in my opinion it is unnecessary and it does stress them out. Now, I do want to say people have different opinions on this. Some people like to get their chameleons out and they claim that they enjoy it. In my opinion, this isn't really the case. Chameleons do stress very easily, and when you know the signs of stress in a chameleon, it is very obvious to see when they're stressed. I am going to cover signs of stress in another video, so make sure if you want to learn all about that, that you know, stick around and wait for that video. It should be out soon. But anyways, handling does tend to stress chameleons out quite a bit, so if you're looking for an animal that you can take out every day and play with, chameleons aren't probably the best pet for you. Chameleons do a lot better when left in their cage. Their cage is their safe spot. Ideally, they should enjoy being in their cage. That's another topic I want to cover. But just in short, if a chameleon is really eager to get out of its cage, it likely means it's stressed inside of its enclosure. Its cage should be a safe spot where it enjoys being. So with all of that said, chameleons, you know, don't really enjoy being handled. If you're looking for a pet that you can have hands-on interaction with a lot, I personally would not recommend a chameleon. However, if you're looking for an animal that you can set up a beautiful display enclosure for and watch them interact with their environment, watch them hunt, watch them move around, watch all of their natural behaviors, then a chameleon might be a really good pet for you. I personally really enjoy just observing my animals. I think that it's really interesting seeing how they interact with their environment. I don't necessarily feel the need to interact with my chameleons hands-on. So because of that, a chameleon makes a good pet for me, but it might not make a good pet for everyone else. Another downside to chameleons is they can be expensive. Not only the upfront cost of actually purchasing the chameleon, but the ongoing cost of feeding them, keeping their cage all set up, electricity, light bulbs, all of that stuff can get expensive. So as I mentioned, the upfront cost for a chameleon can be a lot. You know, depending on where you live, it might be different. For example, I'm in Canada and the costs here tend to be higher than they are in the US, but you know, the same thing still applies. So a common chameleon, like a veiled chameleon, is likely going to be on the cheaper end. And then for example, a Parsons chameleon is going to be on the expensive end. Here in Canada, a veiled chameleon is typically going to go for around $80 to $100. And a Parsons chameleon might go for anywhere from $1,200 to $2,000. These prices are probably going to be a bit different in the US, probably cheaper, but you know, there is an example, they can be expensive depending on what your budget is. Then when it comes to food, you're going to have an ongoing cost because you have to obviously feed your chameleon. And again, depending on what your budget is, feeder insects can get expensive. Since I do have a lot of animals, I do buy crickets in bulk. I buy a box of 1,000 of them and it costs me $30, but depending on where you live and what you have access to, you might be paying way more than this or maybe even less than this. And that box of 1,000 will last me about a week. Again though, like I said, I have a lot of animals. It's not just my chameleons using these insects, it's all of my reptiles. So I spend about $25 a week on crickets, but I would really say that only a few of those dollars go towards my chameleon. But again, depending on what your budget is, what you have access to, what prices are where you live, that's something to keep in mind because it is an ongoing cost. Setting up a proper chameleon cage can also be very expensive. You know, the cage itself can cost a couple hundred dollars depending on what you're buying, or if you're building one yourself, it could be really cheap, it could be really expensive. Then you're going to have to fill the cage with plants and vines and branches and all of that. Those can get expensive. UVB lighting for chameleons can also be expensive, and a UVB light needs to be replaced every 6 to 9 months depending on the brand you're using. So again, this is an ongoing cost. A UVB bulb might cost around $20 to $30 depending on the size you're buying and the brand and where you live. But again, this is an ongoing cost. And also the electricity bill. This is something to keep in mind. My electricity bill with reptiles is significantly higher than someone who doesn't own reptiles. If you just have one chameleon, it's probably not going to make a huge difference, but if you're someone who owns multiple reptiles, this can definitely bring up your electricity bill quite a bit. Now, chameleons can also need vet care. So many people buy animals like reptiles and small animals thinking that they're not going to need vet care like a dog or cat, and this is completely false. A chameleon can need vet care just like any other animal has. I personally have brought two chameleons to the vet before, and now there are negatives to this because one, it can be incredibly hard to actually find a vet who is knowledgeable on chameleons. If you guys have followed my channel for a while, you guys probably know I had a very, very, very bad experience with a vet and one of my chameleons. I'm not going to go into detail, but I'm just saying. It can be difficult to find a vet who is knowledgeable on chameleons. And if you do happen to have a vet who is knowledgeable on chameleons, which I would highly recommend having if you own one, they can get expensive. Now, when I was taking one of my chameleons to the vet, I ended up spending a total of $1,400 throughout his time at the vet. So that is something to consider. Chameleons can rack up vet bills just like a dog or cat can. Another potential negative to a chameleon is that they do have some advanced care. If you're new to reptiles, this could be intimidating for you. Not to say that it's impossible, but it can be a lot to learn and it might be a little bit intimidating. If you're considering getting a chameleon for your first reptile, make sure you're doing a lot of research and really making sure it's the best fit for you, because like I said, it can be quite a lot for a new reptile owner. Compared to a lot of other reptiles, chameleons can be higher maintenance since they do require things like very specific humidity. They require different humidity at night than they do during the day. They need specific temperatures, they need specific lighting, their cages need to be set up a different way, they need adequate hydration, they can be very sensitive to supplements and diets, all of these sorts of things. So it is important to make sure you're prepared for a higher maintenance reptile than something like your standard crested gecko, for example. They're definitely higher maintenance than a lot of the other common animals out there. So all of that said, in conclusion, chameleons do make really awesome pets for the right people. It's incredibly important to make sure a chameleon fits your lifestyle because they really aren't for everyone. I know so many people who can look at a chameleon and think about how beautiful and fascinating and unique it is, but also realize that it's definitely not the right pet for them. So, you know, there's really no one size fits all answer to this question, unfortunately. It would make things simpler if there was, but unfortunately there's not. For someone like me who doesn't mind higher maintenance reptiles, for someone like me who doesn't mind just observing my pets, chameleons make really good pets for me and I enjoy owning them a lot. They're one of my favorite reptiles to keep. But if you're someone who's looking for a pet that you can bond with and take out daily and maybe, you know, doesn't have super high maintenance, you know, a chameleon might not be for you, and that's okay and good to realize before purchasing one. If you're considering getting a chameleon, my biggest suggestion is just do as much research as you can from many different sources. Don't use this video as your only source as to deciding if a chameleon's a good pet for you, because people have different opinions than me, you know, other keepers have different experience than me, and that's totally fine. Check as many sources as you can, you know, read care guides, watch videos, join Facebook groups, forums, books, talk to people who have owned them. Doing as much research as you can is going to best prepare you for a chameleon and really help you decide if it's the right pet for you or not. All of that said, I do hope this video was somewhat helpful to you in deciding if a chameleon is a good pet. As much as I love them, I try not to be biased, because if I were to just say a chameleon is an awesome pet, I love them so much, people might end up getting them and not really being prepared for one, or not really understanding what they're really like, and I don't want that to happen. I want people to be able to get their chameleon and enjoy it for what it is. All of that said, I think I'm going to end the video here. Thank you guys for watching. Again, I hope this was helpful for you. If it was, be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel. As I said, I'm doing a chameleon series, so if you want to learn more about them, be sure to stick around. I will have a lot more videos coming on them in the next little while. All that said, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all in my next video.